Good morning, dear students. Today in this lecture talk, I'll be discussing on antibody structure and functions of immunoglobulin G. Today, let us focus on only immunoglobulin structure and functions. Before I begin today's class, I request you to subscribe this channel to support. I've already given the introduction part related to antibodies and immunoglobulin, but again, let me recall the introduction part related with the antibodies. Okay, antibodies are the specific glycoproteins, also known as immunoglobulin, produced by cells in response to stimulation by an antigen. This antigen can also be known as immunogen and capable of reacting specifically with that antigen. Okay, the antigen which has made the production of antibody, that antibody which reacts with that particular antigen. Okay, every immunoglobulin, in short, they are written as IG. Okay, are the same basic structure made up of four polypeptide chains. We have five different types of immunoglobulin, right? What are those? Let me know. Okay, I told you, right, to remember these immunoglobulins as game D. Game, G for IgG, A for IgA, M for IgM, E for IgE, then D for IgD, right? So these are the five immunoglobulins. In all the five immunoglobulins, you are going to observe the same basic structure representation where you could see the presence of four polypeptide chains, right? In which two heavy chains can be seen here, right? Two heavy chains and two light chains you'll be able to observe, right? In the previous class, hope you already understood, right? This is the one heavy chain and this is the another light chain, right? Which are connected through these disulfide bond. What kind of disulfide bond are these? These are interdisulfide bond, and here also two interdisulfide bond, right? So these are the same basic structure made up of four polypeptide chains, are two heavy chains and two light chains. These chains are held together by non-covalent forces and covalent disulfide bridges. Each chain has a variable part and a constant part of amino acids. I already told you that variable part will be at the tip of this particular immunoglobulin region, right? You can see the amino terminal, and at the bottom you can see the carboxyl terminal. So here you could see the presence of variable part, right? And below the variable part, you can see the constant part of the amino acids, right? In both light chains and heavy chains, you'll be able to see variable part and constant part of the amino acids. By splitting the immunoglobulin molecule using different enzymes, it has been possible to learn the functions of different parts of the molecule. In my first video, I've explained this one. The enzyme pepain splits the molecule into two Fab fragments, Fab says fragment antigen binding, and one FC, that is fragment crystallizable or fragment of crystallization, while the enzyme pepsin splits the molecule into fragment of antigen binding sites, two fragment, and seven small and usually inactive peptides can be seen. It means these immunoglobulin molecules which are susceptible to the enzymes. The differences in the biological activities together with distinct physiochemical properties and different localization have led to the division of antibodies into different classes and subclasses. So this is about the introduction part related with the antibodies. If you want in detail, you can go to my previous video. Now let us focus on one immunoglobulin, that is IgG. We have five different types of immunoglobulin, right? We are classified that way into game D. So let us take the first immunoglobulin G, that is IgG, right? This IgG immunoglobulin molecule, which is a monomer unit. Monomer unit means single immunoglobulin molecule can be seen. This IgG, which is the major immunoglobulin, which is and also most abundant immunoglobulin in human serum, which is comprises of our concentration is 75 to 80% of all the total immunoglobulin. If you want, what you can do, you can make a column of five Okay, all the differences you can write it over there. IgG, IgA, then IgM, IgE, and IgD. Okay, all the four immunoglobulins you can write in these vertical columns, and you can compare, okay, about the immunoglobulin concentration and also the characteristics. Then the highest concentration in serum which was found was the IgG. As I said, as usual, in all the immunoglobulins you have will be having four polypeptide chains or molecule. What are those? Those four polypeptide chain, two light chains are of maybe kappa type or lambda type, and two heavy chains which are of gamma type. So this immunoglobulin we have classified mainly based on the heavy chains. There you observe the gamma type of the amino acids. Okay, whereas in the light chain, you can see the single constant domain, right? And single variable domain can be seen. Okay, in the light chain, you can see only the single constant domain and the single variable domain. Hope you know this particular structure representation. Whereas in heavy chain, you could see single variable domain, okay? But you can see three constant domains. Those three constant domains we named as constant heavy chain one, constant heavy chain second domain, constant heavy chain third domain. Okay, this is the general structure. You can write it for all the immunoglobulins. Greatest amount in internal body fluids and also present in blood, produced particularly during the secondary immune response. Okay, hope you're able to understand here. We already understood that here, greatest amount which are present in the serum, and also whereas here, greatest amount in the internal body fluids, and also present in the blood, produced particularly during secondary immune response. So you must keep in your mind, in Viva or maybe in the MCQ, they may ask this type of question, which is the secondary immune response. Okay, that time you can mention IgG, which is a secondary immune response immunoglobulin. Their molecular weight approximately 150 kilodaltons and their half-life of 23 to 25 days. Okay. Whereas in the structure of the IgG immunoglobulin molecule, you can see the carbohydrate content only 3%. Okay. Whereas based on the antigenic characteristics, we have classified this IgG immunoglobulin molecule into four distinct subclasses. Okay, in those four distinct subclasses, I can see IgG1, IgG2, IgG3, and IgG4. Okay, how we have differentiated mainly based on their antigenicity property. Okay, whereas in IgG1, you could see the presence of two disulfide bond. In IgG2, you can see the presence of 10 to 13 disulfide bonds. In IgG3, also 10 to 13 disulfide bonds. And in IgG4, you can see the presence of two disulfide bonds, but vary in their molecular weight. Okay. So we have classified based on the serum concentration. Okay. Here, this IgG1, which is comprises of 67%, IgG2, 22%, IgG3, 7%, IgG4, 4%. Okay, in all these immunoglobulin subclasses, number of interdisulfide bonds varies. Interdisulfide bond in the sense, in this, whatever, if this is the IgG immunoglobulin structure, So for example, if here you can see the IgG immunoglobulin structure, this is the heavy chain, and again, this is the heavy chain, which are connected, which here you can see the light chain, and here you can see the light chain. Both are connected through single interdisulfide bond. Here, there will be the presence of two interdisulfide bond, or maybe you can see the presence of 10 to 14 disulfide bonds can be seen based on the antigenic property and the number of the disulfide bond which is present between the two immunoglobulins. We classified into four subclasses. Okay. IgG3, which is most effective complement activator. What is a complement activator means? It is a part of immune system that enhances the ability of antibodies and phagocytic cells to clear microbes and damaged cells from an organism which promotes inflammation and attacks pathogens from the plasma membrane. Okay. There are large number in disulfide bond, that is in IgG3. You can see the large amount of the disulfide bond. And also in this IgG, you could see the long hinge region are higher. Because of the long hinge region, these IgG immunoglobulin molecules which exhibit the higher molecular weight. In electron micrographs, this particular IgG immunoglobulin molecule was showed the Y-shaped structure. IgG is named so because of presence of gamma heavy chain, gamma type of heavy chain. It is also called a warm immunoglobulin. IgG class acts against bacteria and viruses by opsonizing the invaders and neutralizing the toxins. What do you mean by opsonization? Opsonization is the process by which pathogen is marked for ingestion and eliminated by a phagocyte. After opsonin binds to the membrane, phagocytes are attached to the pathogen. Opsonizing facilitates phagocytosis, the process of identifying the invading particle to the phagocyte are targeted for destruction by immune cells. Okay. Yeah, here you can go through the definition of this particular opsonization, and usually in the exam they ask you this question, opsonization for 2 marks. Okay, even in antigen antibody reaction, I'll give this particular information again about opsonization. Okay, now I told you here in the previous slide, no, this immunoglobulin molecule, which is very effective complement activator. So here, here you can see the complement activator because of this particular IgG immunoglobulin molecule. And this is about the opsonization process. Here you can see the macrophage, okay? The macrophage, which is going to engulf the extracellular bacteria, whereas these IgG immunoglobulin, which is going to bring the opsonization process, okay? Ingestion by macrophage and digestion in the lysosome, which will be facilitated by this IgG immunoglobulin molecule through opsonization process. Let us understand in brief what is complement system. Okay, anyway, we're going to study separate unit complement fixation or complement system. The complement system is a biochemical cascade of the innate immune system that helps to clear pathogens from an organism. Okay, it is derived from many small plasma proteins that work together to disrupt the target cell's plasma membrane, leading to cytolysis of the cell. The complement system consists of 9 proteins from C1 to C9. What is the C1, C9? You'll understand in the complement. Okay, just only for your reference, I'm telling this one. The complement system is involved in the activities of both innate immunity and acquired immunity. So if time permits, kindly have a look about what is innate immunity and what is this acquired immunity. 2 biochemical pathways activate the complement system. So what are those? Classical complement pathway and alternate complement pathway. The classical complement pathway typically requires antibodies for action and is a specific immune response, while the alternate pathway can be activated without the presence of antibodies and is considered a non-specific immune response. It means what you can keep in your mind here, this immunoglobulin G molecule responsible for the complement, that is classical complement pathway. Okay, where antibodies play a very important role while activating this classical complement pathway. IgG immunoglobulin molecule is the one type of immunoglobulin classes that activates the complement classical pathway. Okay, it is the only immunoglobulin or antibody class which cross the human placenta to provide passive immunity. Passive immunity, that is nothing but the here this IgG immunoglobulin, which is the maternal immunity to the developing fetus. Okay, this is the only immunoglobulin which cross the placenta and give immunity to the newborn baby. Okay, for the newborn, it will persist for several months. If I'm going very quick, kindly pause this video and make a note. Okay, so you can keep in your mind, IgG, immunoglobulin molecule, is the which comes under natural passive immunity. Okay, even we have artificial passive immunity, whereas this is naturally which is happening, which is going to cross the placenta from mother to the a newborn baby. Okay, fetus condition. So this you can keep in your mind as example for natural passive immunity. This IgG immunoglobulin molecule is also maternal antibody. Okay, now let us go to the biological functions of IgG. Okay, the first point here, this IgG immunoglobulin molecule cross the human placenta, thus it can absorb the passive protection to the newborn up to 9 months. Okay, this occurs around in the third month of gestation period. The second point, this is a maternal passive immunity, that is maternal antibody are passed through the placenta to the fetus, neutralizes toxins and viruses. This IgG immunoglobulin molecule activates the classical complement pathway during antigen antibody reaction. IgG opsonizes bacteria and enhances phagocytosis. IgG and specifically IgG4 antibody functions as skin sensitizing immunoglobulin. So this is all about the biological functions of IgG. Okay, this is the general structure of the immunoglobulin. I've already explained you in the previous class. Okay, in the any immunoglobulin, you'll be able to see the presence of two heavy chain and the two light chain. And you could see the variable region in the heavy chain and the variable region in the light chain can be seen. Okay, and below the variable region, you could see the presence of constant heavy chain and constant light chains. And these are the domains. In the light chain, you can see the presence of only two domains, that is variable light chain and constant light chain. Whereas in the heavy chain, other than variable heavy domain, you can see the constant heavy chain first domain, constant heavy chain second domain, and constant heavy chain third domain. All these domains which are connected by disulfide bond. What kind of disulfide bond? Intra disulfide bond can be seen. Okay, you can see here the intra disulfide bond, whereas carbohydrate percentage is how much? Only 4% carbohydrate percentage can be seen. Okay, this is variable heavy chain, constant heavy chain first, constant heavy chain domain second, constant heavy chain third domain, and this region is known as the hinge region. Okay, so from here to here, this region is known as, this is Fab, fragment of antigen binding, and this is fragment of crystallization, a fragment crystallizable. It's responsible for the biological activity of the immunoglobulin. So even you can keep in your mind this particular structure, or you can keep in your mind this particular structure for the general structure of immunoglobulin. Okay. Whereas IgG molecule, if you general structure, you can give either this one or this one. Okay, but while writing the types of immunoglobulin G structure, no, you can write like this. Instead of writing everything, you can write like this. Okay, you can write like this, and you can label this as the first domain and the second domain and the third domain and the fourth domain. Okay, this is variable heavy chain and constant heavy chain one, constant heavy chain two, constant heavy chain three. Whereas this one is a variable light chain, and this is the constant light chain. You must label, and this is the hinge region, interdisulfide bond. Okay, and you can see the presence of 4% of carbohydrate can be seen. And rest you need to label. This is the interdisulfide bond. This is the interdisulfide bond, and here also you can see the presence of intradisulfide bond. Intradisulfide bond. You can label. So this is the IgG1, and this is the IgG2, this is the IgG3 and IgG4. In IgG4, you can see the somewhat extended hinge region. So this is after representation of the IgG immunoglobulin molecule. In general, you can write this for all the immunoglobulin structure, okay? But while writing the individually, the IgG1, IgG2, IgG3, IgG4, you can write this particular structure, okay? Now let us conclude this immunoglobulin G, IgG. The structure is monomer, percentage serum antibody that is 80%, which is the largest in the immunoglobulin pool. Location, blood, lymph, intestine. Half-life in serum, 23 days or 25 days. Complement fixation, yes. What kind of complement fixation? What kind of complement fixation? That was the classical pathway, right? Next one is the placental transfer, yes. Known function, enhances phagocytosis, neutralizes toxins, viruses, and protects fetus and newborn, okay? Hope you understood today's class about the immunoglobulin G molecule, right? So from the beginning, we went through about the immunoglobulin introduction part, right? And we went through the characterization of this particular immunoglobulin molecule, right? Hope you understood this particular today's lecture presentation on IgG immunoglobulin molecule. So first slide, we went through this antibodies introduction, right? And further, we went through the general characteristics of the IgG immunoglobulin molecule, right? And further, we went through their classes, okay? And complement system, right? And then we went through biological functions of IgG, right? This is a structure representation of the IgG immunoglobulin molecule. And this is the summary of the immunoglobulin IgG, okay? Hope you understood today's class IgG immunoglobulin molecule. Here are some questions please try to answer in your free time. On what basis classes of immunoglobulins are named? If you want, you can make a note in your notebook. I'll repeat the question for you. On what basis classes means all the five different types, okay? On what basis classes of immunoglobulins are named, okay? Next question, which immunoglobulin present in mucus? I have not done this one, but in my previous video, I've given the entire tabular representation of all the five immunoglobulins, their structure, types, and their functions, okay? Everything I have given, if you get fine, otherwise you need to search, okay? I'll repeat the second question. Which immunoglobulin present in mucus, okay? Next question, which immunoglobulin indicates acute illness, okay? Next question, which immunoglobulin indicates chronic illness, okay? Next question, which immunoglobulins plays a specific role in parasitic reaction? Okay. Next question, which immunoglobulin is largest in immunoglobulins? Okay. Next question, which immunoglobulin cross the placenta? The next question, which is the primary immune response immunoglobulin? Okay. The next question, which is the secondary immunoresponse immunoglobulin? Okay. The next question, which immunoglobulin we can find in J chain? It means in which structure representation you could see the presence of J chain. Next question, which is the largest immunoglobulin based on their molecular weight? Okay. Next question, which immunoglobulin provides natural passive immunity? Okay. Which immunoglobulin is the smallest in size on the basis of molecular weight? Which immunoglobulin is predominant in saliva? The next question, which immunoglobulin is known as cold immunoglobulin? The last question, which immunoglobulin known as warm immunoglobulin? So these are some of the list of the questions. Kindly try to answer. If you are unable to answer, I'll be giving anyway answer in the next class. Hope you understood today's class, IgG immunoglobulin molecule. I, Dr. Pratibha K, signing out today until we meet again. Thank you for watching this video. Keep watching. Thank you.